Hello everyone. In this video session, I will cover two topics, that is data types in JavaScript and variable, that is how to declare variable in JavaScript. First of all, data type. In many programming language, almost all programming language, there are certain data types which are supported by that particular programming language. Okay. It is not necessary that all kind of data types are supported by all the programming language. For example, in C we have probably you know that C supports integer, float, character, like that. It does not support string, okay? While Java supports string data type. Just like in JavaScript also there is a concept of a data type. That means whatever data that your programming language manipulate, it has a certain types, whether it is a number, whether it is a string, whether it is a boolean, okay, like that. So let's learn. As always, fundamental characteristic of any programming language. Yeah, after that there are types of value that can be represented and manipulated in programming language. Obviously that is our data type. Now in JavaScript it will allow you to work with three primitive data types, that is number, strings and boolean. Now one important thing is that JavaScript does not make a distinction between integer values and float value. You might have probably know that in C there are two different primitive data type, that is integer and float. Okay, that means C differentiate between integer value and floating point value, while in JavaScript it is not same scenario. It doesn't make any difference between integer value or floating value. It just refers to numbers, okay, whether it is a floating point or an integer. All numbers in JavaScript are represented as a floating point value, that means just a number. Now JavaScript variable, okay, variable can be thought of as a named container where you put your stuff, okay. And over here in programming language our stuff is our data. That means a variable is a kind of a container in which we are going to put our data. You can place your data into this container and refer to the data simply by naming the container. That means whenever you want to fetch the data, you just have to refer to that container in which you have put your data. Before you use a variable in JavaScript program, you must declare it. Okay. So how do you declare it in JavaScript? Using var for variable, var keyword. How do you declare? Okay, this is just a simple code where I have declared two variable, that is first one is money and second one is name. You can see that over here I have used variable var keyword, okay, which is followed by your variable name. Till now we have just declared variable names, okay. Now there is another way to declare variable when there are multiple variables, okay. You can see that I can declare a multiple variables name using just a single keyword var. You don't need to write multiple times var keywords. Now in this code I have just declared some variable and assigned some value and just print it out, okay. So let's see, this is our body part in which in paragraph tag I have written demonstration of JavaScript variable, okay. Now whenever I want to write a script of JavaScript, I must have to use script tag, okay. That's why over here it is our script tag. Now in this script tag I have declared two variable, money and name, okay. Now over here I have also assigned value to it, okay. You can see that money is initialized with 2000.50, okay, while var variable name, okay, name is initialized as a John. Now you can see if you have noticed, I haven't used any kind of a data type. That means I haven't specified whether it is this kind of variable. Have I used any integer float or string? No, it is floating point number, but I have used any, even not a number itself. Okay, that means in JavaScript, whenever you want to use variable, you don't need to specify its data type. Okay, now we'll see it later. Now in this program, let's go ahead. After declaring this variable and initialize its value, there are three statements in which I have just printed it on my screen. That means document.write. It is our method to write our content on our web document. And over here, this is our variable name. You can see that this is our variable name. That's why it is not included. It is not in double quote. Okay, be careful about it. Whenever you are printing your variable name, you don't have to use double quote. You just need to just write it down as an argument. Okay, like that. So this is how you declare, initialize, and print out variable in your JavaScript. Now JavaScript is an untyped language. So what does it mean? Untyped, that means loosely typed language. So what does it mean? That means JavaScript variable can hold a value of any data type. Okay. Now let me just give you reason why I haven't used data type while declaring my variable. Now JavaScript is a loosely typed language. That means it can hold any kind of value during our program. For example, in this previous slide, you can see that money is holding number value. Okay, but if I write money is equals to let's say 20, but in string form. Okay, TWENTY, like that, then it is also true. That means it will not throw you an error in JavaScript, but it is possible that it will throw an error in C or Java language. Okay, now unlike many other languages, you don't have to tell JavaScript during variable declaration what type of value the variable will hold, because it can hold any kind of value during your program execution. That's why you don't have to specify. Value type of a variable, it can change during the execution of a program, and JavaScript take care of it automatically. You don't have to handle it in any specific way. You just simply assign its value, that's fine. Now this is some exercise for you. Declare one variable and pop up it as an alert box. And now you assign a different value. First, when you have declared, it was number. Now you are assigning string value. Okay, now put it in alert box. Now you have assigned some floating point, partial number. Okay, and you just need pop-up box, alert box, you have to use it. Okay, now this last statement, it is a concatenation of one is your string and another x is your number. Okay, now you are concatenating. Now just watch this value in your while when you just practice it. Okay, it's your homework. Now JavaScript variable scope of a variable is region of your program in which it is accessible. In C programming language, there is also concept of a variable scope. Okay, now what does it mean, scope? Now I have said it, that variable name is kind of container in which you are going to store your data. Okay, now the point is that you cannot just refer to your container from anywhere. There are certain rules and limitation to use your container. Okay, so this is related to this scope. So over here in JavaScript, there are variable has a two scope. That first one is a global variable and second one is a local variable. Now what is global variable? A variable that is declared outside of a function. Okay, so that is global variable, while local is just opposite of that. That means a variable that is declared inside a function definition, it is local. Now whenever you access global variable, it is accessible and modifiable throughout your program. Okay, while local variable, it cannot be accessed from anywhere in your code outside the function. You can access it only in function, only within the function, not from anywhere else. Okay, now second important thing is that global variable created only once. Okay, and local variable it created as many times whenever you execute that function, that particular function. That is the difference between global variable and local variable. Now let's see example of it. Okay, now within the body of a function, local variable takes precedence over a global variable with the same name. What does it mean? For example, I have used declared one variable, let's say variable 1 as a global. Okay, and with same name I have also declared local variable within function, let's say local variable 1. So in function, within function, your local variable take precedence over global variable. That means in within function name you are accessing local variable, not global variable. If you declare a local variable or a function parameter with the same name as a global variable, you effectively hide the global variable. Now this is a example. You can see that this is our script tag. Now within script, it is not a function. Let me mention you that script is a tag, so that your browser can understand that whatever code is ahead, it is a JavaScript. Okay, it is not a part of a function. So within script tag, I have declared one variable, that is var, my variable, and I have assigned its value, string value, that is global. So over here, it is outside any function. That means you are declaring global variable. Okay, now you can see that over here I have declared one function using function keyword. There is no parameter, and within function there is also one variable with same name, that is my variable. Okay, but see, there is different over here, it is a different value that assigned to this variable, that is local variable. How can you identify it is local variable? Because it is declared in within the function. Okay, so within this function, whenever I output it as a output in my window, let's say I'm going to write it out, variable name, my variable. So what will be print out? What will be print out? Whether it is global or local? But obviously it will be local, okay, because you are accessing local variable. Though you have declared global variable with same name, but it will not print it out in function. But if you write outside function, then it will be global variable. Okay, now JavaScript variable name. While naming your variable name in JavaScript, there are certain rules that you should follow as a good programmer. Okay, so these are the rules. You should not use any of the JavaScript reserved keyword as variable name. Now there are certain keywords that are reserved for programming itself. You cannot use it as your variable name or even a function name. Okay, for example, in this for example, break or a boolean variable, variable names are not allowed because it has a specific meaning this programming language. That's why you cannot use it. JavaScript variable name should not start with a number, that means up to 0 to 9. Okay, they must begin with a letter or the underscore characters. So I have just specified some valid or invalid names. Let's say 123 state, is it valid? No, because it has started with number, that's why it is invalid. Okay, now this is valid. Yeah, it is valid. Why? Because it start with underscore. JavaScript variable name are case sensitive. That means this name and this are two different variable. But obviously, as I said, you JavaScript is a case sensitive language. There are certain As I have mentioned you in earlier slide, there are certain reserved keywords in JavaScript. You should not use it as a variable names or function names, method names, or a loop or loop label, or by any means. Okay, so these are the important keywords that are reserved in JavaScript. You should not use it. So that's all about JavaScript variable name, data types. Okay. For keep practice and to show that you just understood this concept well. Bye bye.